Hi everyone, my name is Chris Keller and today we're just going to go through a tutorial about how to remove your background noise in Cubase 5. That's if you have having problems with removing that unwanted background noise in your audio recordings. So let's just go straight into some of the tools that you can use to help you remove that background noise. So I have several plugins that you can use, of which four Waves plugins, and the first one is actually a stock plugin, that's the denoiser. So the denoiser is one of the tools that you can use, and how you use it is basically by pulling this knob down. The more you go down, the less the noise, basically. So let's just see how that works. So already you can tell there is already background noise going on in the background. Let's try to bring it down just for preview sake. Already you can tell that there is no noise, but this obviously won't work if you're playing the recorded audio. That would be like too much. So let's try to see how we can. Hi everyone, my name is Chris Keller and today we're just going to go through it. Okay, so that's about it. That already shows you how to use it. So hope that will work. If you have a good mic, then you won't have to reduce much. So most of the work will be on how much you want to remove and or not. So that will be up to your test. Otherwise, that's basically how you use that. And from this simple demonstration, obviously you're able to tell that it's as easy as that. So let me go to the next plugin. And let me just bring this down because that is actually one of the easiest plugins to use, similar to the denoiser, and I'll put it last. So the next plugin is the X noise. Now how you use this X noise is, first you have to loop around an area which only has noise, you record that, and this is how you use it. Let me just show you. So hi everyone, my name is Chris Keller and today we're just going to so the next thing that you do while you are playing it is press this button called learn. So this is the wave of the noise in the background. So after that is done, you can just press this button again and this white line will remain showing your the information having or found in the noise file. So once you have that, the next thing you do is now you can play the whole file. And hi everyone, my name is Chris Keller and today we're just going to try to lift this white line above this red line, because this red line is representing the audio file information. Hi everyone, my name is Chris Keller and so I think that's about it. Once you do that, the next thing is to lift this button. The higher you go, the less noise you hear. So let me show you. Hi everyone, my name is Chris Keller and today we're just going to go through a tutorial about how to remove your back. Just by doing that, I'm sure you are able to hear the difference in sound. It took away the noise in the background, and as you can tell, there's no noise in the background. So that's how you use this plugin. So similar to the X noise, though very different, this one works a bit different. For this plugin, you first have to go to an area where you're having noise, like we did on the X noise, and then you play it. And as you can see, there is this yellow line that has come through. So this is like the X noise plugin. This actually shows you some information on how you would have to cut this EQ, and by doing so you remove the background noise. So doing that manually might take long. So Waves has this button called the suggest button, and immediately you press that, that happens. So you don't have to do it manually, thank God. So once that happens, the next thing you do is, because right now where it sits, which is negative 20 dB, is like too much, like reducing it too much. So first of all, you bring it down. Okay, let me just play so that you understand what I mean by it's too much. So in short, zero means it's already active. It's like 100%. So the less you go, the less reduction you have. So let me just play the whole file now, and then we try to...
Hi, everyone. My name is Chris Keller, and today we're just going...
So I think already that is enough. So that's how you use this plugin.
Hi, everyone. My name is Chris Keller, and today we're just going to...
And by the way, those who are wondering why I have this on is mainly so that you're able to hear the voice easily, because without it, the voice would have been low. So anyway, let me go to the last plugin, which is the NS1 plugin. Let me switch that off. The NS1 plugin by Waves. And this plugin, the higher you go, the less reduction you have. It's one of the easiest plugins. You don't have to do any analyzing and stuff like that. So let me just go ahead.
Hi, everyone. My name is Chris Keller, and...
I think you could tell what has just happened. Without it, you can hear that background noise, but just putting it on, because this is the default. Bring it back so that you're able to... This is the default, but just putting it on without doing anything, you already have that noise gotten rid of. That's how much amazing this plugin is, and this is why it's one of my favorite, right? So already you don't have that background noise. So if you ever needed to, maybe we just increase it to about 5, I think that would be more than enough.
Hi, everyone.
So that's about it. Hope you enjoyed. Hope I was clear enough. And be sure to subscribe to my channel and share, leave a like. Thank you very much. And hope this makes it easy for you to remove that unwanted background. So thank you very much.